I'm trying something a little bit different today. I'm actually streaming on my Mac because I got this. So as you can see here it is, the Game Park GP32, which is a really interesting handheld console that came from Korea originally. It's got a really nice design. This is the BLU, the backlit unit, or backlight unit. This one was made in 2004, I believe, and the original version came out in 2001, so a few years after. And as you can see, when you turn it on, it's actually got quite a nice screen for the time. And you've got the option to use PC link with the USB port right there. Let me know whether you can hear me okay. I've got the microphone sort of lined up in between me and the console, so hopefully you can pick up both sounds at once. I'll try and move it a little bit closer like that. So here's how the menu looks. Very, very simple. You've got play or you've got PC link. There's no other options, as far as I can tell anyway. When you go on PC Link, that's the screen that shows up there, asking to put in the USB or the SMC, which is the smart media card. And they're really interesting. So let me show you what these look like. These are the smart media cards. They're a lot bigger than SD cards. And the one that I got came with three or four. So there's three here. And there's one that's in the Mac right now, and that's why I'm streaming this on the Mac. So that's what the cards look like. And let me find a USB to compare it with. I thought I had one there. I must have one somewhere. There's one. Let's open up a brand new one. There's a regular SD card size. A micro SD adapter, but an SD card size anyway. But the smart media cards are a lot bigger. Like, from looking at it on a picture, you can't really tell the size, but when you show them side by side like that, there's a massive difference. So it's really interesting to see how they look. And they slot in the top here like that, with the gold bit facing forward. So they're just going like that. It's quite stiff to push them down, and it's kind of hard to pull them out as well. Like, you've only got this tiny little bit there to grip onto, and there's nothing on the back. So getting your thumb in there and holding on as tight as you can is the best way to do it, and then pull that off. But the reason that I've started streaming on the PC is because, if we have a look on here, here's the card in here. Look, GP2, GP32, and I've actually put a bunch of games on here, and these are all retail games as well. And it took me a while to figure out the best way to get this set up. So you have this XFEX file, which is the GP32 game file itself. And then you need to put the game in a separate folder over here. And if we go to, not downloads, if we go to 18 terabytes, backup, GP32, GP32 collection, I actually downloaded basically every GP32 game there is, all of the official games anyway. And I've extracted a bunch here and put those onto the card. But as well as that, if we move that out of the way for a second, and if I share Safari instead, not that Safari, the other one, that will just be Tunnel Vision. I also found this website here, which is an archived site, which actually has a lot of downloadable stuff for the GP32, including demos, applications, development stuff, emulators. And that's actually emulators for other consoles. So we've got some MAME stuff on there. We've got Atari 2600. And there's a bunch of other ones as well. There was another card that came bundled with some NES and Mega Drive emulators even, which is pretty cool. And there's also games here. There's demos for commercial games, all sorts of things. A GP32 version of a GBA game, that'll be interesting to see the comparison. But yeah, as you can see, there's a bunch of things here. There's even a visual novel. So let's try downloading one. Let's check this out here. So this is called Super Plusher Demo. Oh, and also some people on Twitter actually told me that back in the day, they actually built GP32 games themselves, which is really cool. So maybe we'll even check out some of them a bit later on. So let's get that downloaded and I'll put that onto the card. It's kind of difficult sharing this screen. I've not tried the window capture like this before, so bear with me if this is a little bit awkward. And let me know how you guys are all doing as well. Right, I think that's the right folder. Yep, if we go back in GP32. And then if I open up, it's really difficult as well because I've got the camera in the way, so I can't really see. So this one here, SP demo. I know, it's moved the keyboard out of the way. So that one goes in there, paste that in there. It is quite slow moving stuff back and forth between one of these smart media cards, but hopefully this is only a small game. It won't take long. Some of the bigger ones took like 5+ minutes to move over, and they're only a few megabytes. So it's kind of funny. Even that, look, it's taking a long time. And when the size shows up there, you'll see it's just like a few megabytes. So these cards were like super, super slow, even for back in the day. There we go. And that was, let's see, get info. Oh, you guys can't see, but that was 1.6 megabytes. That's crazy. Right, anyway, I think we've got a good bunch of stuff on there to check it out. So let's eject that. And I'll stop sharing that. And we can actually check out what it looks like on the system. There we go. And if you wanted to see how I'm actually getting the stuff onto this, I picked this up on Amazon, which is a USB-C to smart media card adapter. Like, why would anyone even make this in 2024? But anyway, there we are. And this was the biggest card I had as well. This one's 128 megabytes. The other ones are 64 and 16. So I guess that was the different range of sizes for these cards as well. So let's put this one in and fingers crossed it all works. I did try it out earlier and it seemed fine. So fingers crossed. Let me know whether you can hear the sounds from the console as well, by the way. Here we go. Unfortunately, doing it on the Mac, it does come up with all these blank files as well. But it looks like everything moved over properly, which is good. So let's check out this game here, which was the demo that we just downloaded off that website. And it seems like something was missing. I knew this wouldn't go well straight off the bat. Maybe we'll come back to that one in a bit. Let's check out instead. I don't even know what this is. Is it going to load? Okay, something's loading. Pre-calculations. It's doing a lot of them. Oh, okay. This was another one I downloaded that I thought looked really cool. This is apparently based on F-Zero. So can you see that on the screen? Okay. It's really throwing me off as well. Select is on the right and start is on the left. That just doesn't make any sense. That's so backwards. Wow. Okay, that's actually pretty impressive for a console that was from 2001. Like, yeah, it's pre-rendered, but... Oh, no. It's so interesting. There's so many, like, weird fan-made games and projects for this system. It's going to be so much fun diving into it. It's really impressive. Like, I think this was on par with the Game Boy Advance, or maybe even slightly more powerful. I'll have to look at some stats and stuff before I do my full video on it, but really cool to see. Oh my god, the turning's horrible on this. Looks like you've got to use the brake quite a lot. Really impressive though, I like the lens flare too. And the frame rate's surprisingly good. And this console itself has a fascinating history as well. I can't wait to do some research and do a proper video on why it exists and how it came to be and everything. And the fact that it actually has proper commercial releases as well is really, really interesting. Because a lot of these consoles were obviously just made with emulators in mind. But as this was Korea's first attempt at a game console, they actually did have some proper first-party releases and proper commercial games for it. But they're so difficult to find. I'm actually watching every single one of them that's on eBay right now. But they're all, like, multiple hundreds of pounds. So it's very difficult to actually get a hold of any of them. We'll see whether I can actually finish all three laps and see whether there's a second track. It's a little bit slow to accelerate. But yeah, let me know in the chat or in the comments if you're watching this afterwards. Has anyone heard of the GP32 before? Do you know anyone that had one? Did you have one yourself back in the day? I know one person. Well, actually, I know two people that had one in person. And I know a bunch of people on Twitter did as well when I was sharing the fact that I bought this the other day. Quite a few people seemed quite excited that I'd picked one up, so that's pretty cool. It's a really neat bit of gaming history for sure. Oh no! I was so close to finishing that lap then. Alright, well that was Giro, or Gyro. Really impressive tech demo, I guess. Let's boot it back up and see what else is on here. Great, let's see what we've got here. Unfortunately, that first game we downloaded didn't work. It said the game files were missing. I think these ones are official releases. That one, Blue Angelo, that is one that I really want to try and get a physical copy of. Because that was actually a cancelled Game Boy Advance game, which is really interesting in itself. And it was also a failed Kickstarter. They were going to bring it back for PC, which I always thought was really interesting. Oh, it is working. Yay, here we go. This one is by a company called Seed9 Entertainment. Oh yeah, and if you want to see, let's just mute that for a second. If I share my notes, wherever that is, you should be able to see here, I've actually got pictures of a lot of the physical releases, and these are obviously extremely difficult to find. But there you go, that's what the boxes look like. I think they look really cool. And there's the Blue Angelo one that I really want. It's super, super hard to find. Apparently the best game on the system is... Well, that one keeps getting talked about a lot. That one called Kimchi Man is supposedly a really fun platformer. That one looks really nice. I've got an English fan translation of that one. I love the style of that one. There was another one as well. Don't really know anything about that one at all. But that's every official release, I think. And I've got a bunch of links here to different places as well. And what else have I got? A bit of a script that I've been working on. And nothing in that one. But yeah, there's a bunch of links to different places where I've basically gathered up every little bit of information that I can find about the GP32. But yeah, hopefully in the future I'll be able to show off some of these in person. I've got no idea what that one is. With like a stick insect or a leaf or something. And obviously the other issue is that most of the games are all in Korean, which isn't much use to anyone. Outside of Korea at least. But this one seems to have an English menu at least. So let's just try arcade. Oh, so we've got three different characters to choose from. And they have different speed and power stats. Let's just start off with this character here and see what they're like. And I have no idea what this actual game's like either, so hopefully it's not too confusing. And hopefully you can all see the screen okay. Oh nice, it's a shoot 'em up. Kind of reminds me of Air Zonk, or those kind of shooters that you'd find on the PC Engine. This is really cool, actually, because the GBA doesn't really have many shoot-em-ups, especially horizontal ones. Sounds like it's got a nice soundtrack as well. Bit difficult to hear with the headphones on, but I have them on so I can hear what's happening on the stream. Annoyingly, you have to keep mashing the A button to shoot. And I'm getting a little bit of glare off the screen from having these lights on in the room too. But I'm genuinely really impressed by this. I'll definitely try and track down a physical copy. Can you all see it okay? Let's try and see what I mean about the glare. Like, I wonder if I turn these lights off. Okay, that looks better. It makes me extremely blue. I wonder whether I can just turn them down like that. Hey, that's better. There we go. That should be a bit easier to watch. Maybe I can try playing it on the preview. Definitely feels very similar to AirZonk. Nice graphics too. And I was really impressed with the graphics in the Blue Angelo game. They actually have proper parallax scrolling, which even the GBA doesn't really have, so very impressive for the time. I want to try and find out more about the company who made this too, because it'll be really fascinating to see whether they actually had any experience with making game consoles before this, because obviously Korea was kind of banned from video game consoles. Same thing that happened in China. At least as far as I know, anyway. Uh-oh, we're approaching a boss. You can't hold the A button down. That's the one downside to this game. It'd be great if you could hold it down. I have a bomb kind of thing, I think. I don't know whether it's taken any damage or not. There's nothing to show whether the boss is actually taking damage. Oh, is that its health at the bottom of the screen, I think. The sound effects are drowning out the music. Oh yeah, I have no idea how the battery life is on this either. I've got a bunch of batteries on the table with me that we'll swap in and out if needs be, but hopefully it's alright. There we go, first boss down. There you go, you can get a close-up of what the graphics look like. Really impressed so far with everything I've seen from it. Hey, pass the plunger. Oh, it doesn't seem like the chat's working on the stream. Never mind. I can see you anyway. Hello. This is actually my first time seeing a GP32 in person as well, and it feels really nice too. Like, the build quality is very, very solid. Feels like a premium device. It does have these weird lumps on the back though, which is a bit strange. There we go, level 2. Everything's out of focus. There we go. I'm not using my regular streaming PC today, so... Oh, it is working. It's just going the wrong way around. I wonder how many people have actually played this game. I doubt any of the games sold very well for it. Is it good to hold? Yeah, it's good. I'm planning to do a video. Yeah, this is basically me testing it out for the first time. It's really nice to hold, actually, and it's really high quality plastic too, like on par with the Game Boy Advance, I'd say. This was the third revision of the system, so I don't know whether the other two are any different. Oh, one weird thing. Have a look at the D-pad. Like, yeah, it looks like a normal D-pad, but it's actually like a stick, which is really interesting. And it feels kind of like the Neo Geo Pocket. I don't know whether you can hear, but it's got that clicky micro switch feeling to it. Actually feels really nice. It took me a bit of getting used to not, like, you don't press down on the arrow, you actually move your thumb side to side to move it, which is kind of different, but it sounds really nice. So yeah, I'm really impressed. And I did actually try out some of the emulators on here as well, and it seems like it can run Mega Drive at almost full speed, which obviously for a console from 2001 is pretty impressive. There wasn't really any alternative that could emulate anything before then. So this really was like the start of the handheld emulation scene. And it turns out that a lot of people who make Game Boy Homebrew and stuff these days actually got their start making games for the GP32 back in the day, which is really cool. And I've actually got someone on Twitter who sent me their game to try out, so we can try that out in a bit too. And you'll see why I've streamed from my Mac today, so that I can actually transfer all files over and show you the process as well. But we'll play this one for a bit longer first. Let's turn the sound back up. I'm not doing very well. There's a lot going on the screen as well, and there's no sprite flicker or anything, so... genuinely impressed. Oh, there we go, I died. We'll leave it there for now. If I share my screen again, here's a look at some of the actual physical releases for the system, and that's what makes this unique compared to a lot of these other emulation handhelds. They were actually trying to make this one a proper... I've lost the chat. Where's the chat gone? They released an Ericsson keyboard. Do you want to see it? Hold on. It is right here. Here it is. Yep, Ericsson chat keyboard with really, really tiny buttons. And that goes in the bottom there. So that goes in that extension port like that. There we go. I don't know what can actually use it. Well, actually I do, because you can actually get some text adventures on here, some old PC text adventures, and use this to actually like interact with the games. So that's really fun. Maybe we can try and find some things that use that. The keyboard's very thin, as you can see. It's just a little sheet of plastic. Feels all right, though. Kind of reminds me of using a BlackBerry back in the day. So it's really nice. Really high quality, obviously, as it is Ericsson. Bit of a blast from the past. I haven't seen that logo in a long time. But yeah, everything feels so nice and sturdy. I'll show you what the cards look like. They're kind of weird. They're these, like, giant SD cards. Like, compare it to a regular SD card. See how much bigger it is. And they barely hold any space. This is the biggest one you could get. That's 128 megabytes. Yep. And we've also got a bunch of other ones here. There's a 64 meg one. And 16 meg. And another 64 one as well. And these all have different things on from the original owner. And to get them to actually read, I don't know why they still make this, but on Amazon, I managed to pick this up, which is a modern reader for these cards. So you put that in, and it's actually got USB-C on the other end. So I can plug that straight in there into the Mac and actually just boot it up straight away, which is really, really cool. And I was just surprised that it could read it, because I was not expecting it to be able to read it straight away. So let me figure out what window we're looking at here. This one. So coming down here. Here's how the files look on the system. It is very slow to read and write. Yeah, thank you, China, making sure we can still read all these weird old formats. And thank you, Apple, for still accepting them too. So what I've actually got, and we can try putting some other stuff on here. If we go into this backup, I actually downloaded off archive.org a list of every single official game for the system in a zip. So, oh, I think the screen shares stopped working. Let's try that again. GP32 collection. There we go. There, you should be able to see it a bit better. So I've got a list here of all of the official releases. And let's try this one. They've got cracked versions as well, which sort of bypasses any kind of copy protection. You want to know how big the entire folder is with everything? It is. It's probably laughably small. 732 megabytes. And that's including all the BIOS files and everything, and multiple versions of the same game in different languages. So that's pretty funny. So the way it works is they come in two different files here. So this took me a bit of time to figure out earlier. If we call that treasure, and then what you need to do is move this half, this bit, copy that. I think the sharing's frozen again. It really doesn't like me doing this. Go into game, paste it in there. Every time I change a tab, I think it's getting confused. Oh, that'd be good if you could use a micro SD card. I don't think they would fit, actually. Right, let's hide that for a second. Look how thin they are, even compared to an SD card. I don't even think a micro SD would fit in that. It's so thin, it actually bends. So it's literally just paper thin with a massive gold bit on the front. So half of that's copied over, and then you go into this folder. I know you can't see it, but I'll do it now. And we can check this one out. And as well as that, there was also a preloaded card with a bunch of emulators and things on too. And some more homebrew games. They had a Commodore 64 emulator, a version of Bomb Jack. Let's try that. See if we can get that to work. They have a Game Boy and Game Boy Advance emulator too. Should we try an Mega Drive emulator too? Let's see whether there's enough space to put both of these on there. It is copying things over. It's incredibly slow. Like, this is only a few megabytes, and look how long it takes to transfer the files. I forgot cameras used to use those smart media cards. I think it did actually have an issue of Edge dedicated to it back in the day. I knew about it from magazines back then as well. And then when I started college a few years later, one of my friends had the GP2X, which is the second revision of the system, which is a little bit better. Right, let's eject that and we can check out some of the new games and potentially emulators as well. It'll be interesting to see how emulators fare on this. But yeah, Game Park themselves, the developers of this, the Korean developers, they're a really interesting company, and they actually made a bunch of different handhelds. They made this one. They made another one called the 2X, which is basically the same, but more of a media machine, like an all-in-one multimedia device, and it didn't have the official games like this one did. Yeah, I actually got this for a good deal, I think. I got it for 70, 75, something like that. Which is actually a lot cheaper than the games themselves are. So I was happy with that. So put that in. That's how the games go in, just face first like that. And it's kind of weird that they stick out, even though there's not anything to grip them with. It'd be nice if... Well, I guess it was just a standard card format, wasn't it? So there's not much they can do about that. So from what I was reading, this did well in Korea when it was first released. What order is it putting these in? Maybe some of the newer things didn't move over. Apparently this is one of the easier to find games. I might try and track this one down. Die Hard. D-Y. Die Hard. Let's check this out. I think this one's a platformer. No, it doesn't eject. It doesn't do anything. It's actually got some digitized voices on this one as well. That's pretty cool. Okay, I have no idea what to expect with this. Let's try arcade mode. Whoa, okay. It's like an iPhone game or something. I don't understand these controls. So he walks all by himself, and I guess all you can do is jump. Oh, it's weird. You hold the jump button down. Oh, I say, look at the top corner there. So the longer you hold the button down, you have to time it so that power meter doesn't go too far. This is a really weird way of controlling a platformer. So like that was a full power jump. Ah, this is almost like a precursor to one of those iPhone games. It also has a story as well. Let's see what options there are. Difficulty. Direction. Okay, interesting. Pretty cool background on there too. Maybe it's just loading back to the front screen. There we go. Let's try again. See whether we can actually get anywhere. And it looks like you can press B to use a jetpack as well. Whee! And you can actually steer with the jetpack, but... No, oh my god, this is really awkward. I guess so. I'm surprised they just didn't actually call it Die Hard. I don't think South Korea had many copyright protections back in 2001. And apparently, this console did actually get a release in... Oh my god, I really suck at this. Apparently, the console did actually get a release in Europe as well. I didn't really know that, but apparently it came out in places like Spain and Brazil in 2002 or 3. Because the... Whatever law they had in Korea was basically removed in the early 2000s. And then to keep Game Park afloat, they tried to sell the GP32 overseas. Ah, I got a little bit further. This is so weird. I've never played a platformer like this before. The graphics are nice, but man, I suck at this. I don't think it came out in the UK at all. At least not officially. You could probably get it on websites as a mail order thing. Ah! I know that PlayAsia used to sell it along with the... should we try the story mode? Let's see what the story mode's like. I know PlayAsia used to sell it along with the actual retail releases. Okay. It's basically Die Hard Korea version. And it's in English as well. At this moment, the explosives are most likely here, here, and here. PlayAsia and Lixang was the other place. That website doesn't exist anymore. It's not too bad. It's got a backlight, this version has. So there's three different versions. This one's the BLU, the backlight version. So if I turn the lights off completely, you can see. It's not that bad, actually. Probably a little bit worse than the Game Boy. I don't know. Maybe it's on par with the SP, actually. I think it looks pretty good. Obviously, the viewing angles aren't great. But yeah, you don't need to be under a light to play it, which is brilliant. Why wasn't I able to jump then? The first release was like the GBA style screen. Let's try that. Rah! I used to browse Lixang back in the day as well, when all the weird import Game Boy stuff was on there. I don't know what happened to that site. I guess they got shut down for copyright reasons or something. I think it was a Hong Kong-based site. I know my friend Quang was in one of their coding competitions for a Game Boy game back in the day, when they were doing their Game Boy Color homebrew competitions on the website. I am actually getting somewhere. Should I try using another rocket? I feel like once you've mastered the controls here, it's actually a really fun game. It definitely feels like a precursor to a kind of app game. Not bad. Got a 9. Shut down due to importing. Yeah, that's probably it. Right, let's check out what else I've got on here. I don't know why that other stuff that I put on there didn't copy over properly. I don't know whether I did something wrong. I'm still trying to figure it all out, really. And although it says PC link here and it does have a USB port, apparently this is a specific USB port just for this console, and it's actually harder to find than the machine itself, so I won't be able to plug it into the computer. But luckily the card reader seems to work okay, or partially okay anyway, because I got some stuff on. Oh, some of it did work. That Treasure Island game came across. But the Mega Drive emulator didn't. Right. Let's check out this one. The graphics look really nice on this one from what I've seen so far. Yeah, I have no idea what that port is. Never seen it before in anything. Oh, that one didn't work either. Let's try that one again and see what it says. No, it's just kicking me back out. That's a shame. I was looking forward to trying that one. I'll have to mess around with it a bit more before my video and see whether I can get any of these other things to work. Let's try this Treasure Island one then. This was the new one that I put on. Is it going to load? Come on. What are the shoulder buttons like? They're very, very soft. They don't click at all. You can't even hear them. I quite like it actually, because a lot of these consoles, like this one. This was one that I reviewed a while back. They're like super, super clicky shoulder buttons. Whereas these are just soft like sponge. Oh, that one's not loading either. I guess that's luck of the draw, whether these games actually work on it. They kind of feel like the original GBA, but a little bit harder to press. I don't know whether many games actually use them or not. Let's see, what haven't we tried? We haven't tried this one. Come on, fingers crossed, something's got to work. Here we go, we have sound. Yay, this one worked. Oh, I did get another handheld I'll be doing a video on soon as well. This really nice looking Game Boy Micro style one by Miu. Like, their new version of the Miu Mini, but in horizontal format. Which I really like. Anyway. Maybe they would. It was more powerful, but these games were all exclusive to this version, so it should be fine. Okay, let's try this one. This one seems to be in English too, which is great. I tried to download as many English language patches as I could. So we have a choice of 5 characters. I presume this one's a fighting game by the looks of it. Let's go with this guy here. He uses a long katana. Ability, invincible. Oh, you get to choose from 3 different abilities. So we can have invincible, restoration, or recovery. I don't know what the difference between those two are. Let's go for invincible. They all sound pretty good. How's the focus? Is it focusing on the screen okay? A little bit blurry, isn't it? There we go. You know that I'm getting married tomorrow. Yes, I know. So that is no, I'm sorry. It's all right. Please say it, princess. Nice full screen, full color picture. Let's run away, Asgard. I know this is bad form, but please come get me before it's too late. Oh, nice. Nice graphics. Not what I was expecting. Finally, I'm here. Let's get moving. Okay, so we got a sword. Got a stab. Okay, we can sheath the sword or bring it out. There's a cool animation for when he does that. Okay, got a punch and a kick. Why am I facing backwards? Let's just get the sword out. Where's his sword gone? There we go. Wow, nice. There's a pumpkin on the floor. Where's the sword gone? Oh no. Let's see if the L and R buttons do anything. Okay, we got a block button. I'm not really sure what's going on. There's a lot going on, and I'm dead. Let's try that again. Oh my god, let's try that again. That was terrible. Instant death right there. No, it doesn't seem like they're doing anything. Okay, select. Oh, select is the special attack. Okay, that made me invincible. Is it like an RPG mixed with a beat 'em up? Because there's loads of other stuff going on. Look how cool he is. He's kicking them with his hands in his pockets. I need to get my sword back. Let me get my sword. There we go. Let's get him. Maybe I can only use the sword sometimes. Okay, I think I hit that guy with a book for some reason. When you get the sword out, it moves really slowly. Right? Really, really slow. Ah, as soon as I move the screen, there's a bunch of people there. I'm going to die. Take these guys out, quick. Whoa, how did I manage to take that out in one go? Let me up, let me up! Stab, stab, stab. No, I'm not very good at this. Game over. Okay, let's try. There was a training mode as well. Expansion. Don't know what that is. Config? Was I playing on extra hard or something? But you have to learn to block, maybe. Crazy hard. Okay. I was on normal, apparently. Let's try training, see what we actually have to do in this. Seems like a good game, though. Like, if this came out on the Game Boy Advance, it wouldn't feel out of place. Shame no one really ever got a chance to play it. Let's try a different character, too. Okay, we get to fight a dummy. I like the animation. It's very expressive. Okay, looks like he doesn't put his weapon away, which might make it a bit easier. L&R don't do anything. You'd think they would use the L&R buttons. Oh. I wonder if there's combos. Okay, if you're standing still, then you'll do that. And if you're moving and hold down B, I guess B is for heavy attacks. I just muted myself for a second. I needed to sneeze. Set default position. Okay, that just... Okay, we can make the AI fight as well. Cool. Huh, thank you. So he's actually going to fight back this time. Oh my god, they're way too strong. Maybe it depends on how far or close you are to the enemy as well as to what attack you do. That seems like a good one. Alright, let's try that same level again with this character. Oh, I just realised as well, it's got a headphone port, so when I make my video, I can actually plug that into the computer and record the audio straight from the game. It also has volume slider there, and it also has a DC input as well if you want to play it without batteries. And for batteries, it just takes two AA batteries. So that's pretty cool. Alright, let's try again. With invincibility. Can we skip? Really? They didn't think that you would see this more than once. Okay, let's go. Oh, that's so much better. Yeah. Oh, we do have a run button as well. And double tap to do a back jump as well. I guess if you run, you also get different attacks. The frame rate's a little low, but it doesn't really impact this kind of game. That's a cool attack. Going with a heavy attack. Will we actually be able to get past level one this time? Oh my god, still can't even get past the first stage. I really suck at this. I'll have to try and have some practice on this one. Let's try a different game. I think there's a few more in here. It's nice and responsive how fast it is to turn on and off as well. Like some of these new systems, like if we turn this one on, you have to hold the button on the side for like a good few seconds before anything even happens. And then you have to wait for it. Whereas this came on pretty much instantly. So not everything is an improvement in the modern day. Like, look how long that took. And then you don't know whether you've held it down long enough to turn it off or whether you've just held it down long enough to go into sleep mode. So there we go. Power off. So I do like having a physical power button. That one didn't work. Blue Angelo is one that I wanted to check out. This one's kind of like a Metroid-style game. And I mentioned this one on my channel in the past. This was actually going to be a Game Boy Advance game as well. But that one got cancelled. This one did get released in 2004, but it was very, very limited. A very limited release. But it looks really cool, and I've been very excited to try this one. So let's give it a go. Here it is. And before we do, oh no, it's fine. I'll just play it. I was going to show you what the GBA one looks like as well, but I'll save that for the video. So let's go. Well, that's a weird effect when you enter a letter. All right, let's see what this is like. Got a nice background graphic there. So it's a humans versus demons story. Every 30 years, demons would get stronger. Yay, the humans can live in peace, I guess, until now. I don't think you play as a human, from what I've seen. So maybe I'm the one coming to kill all the humans. Looks like a fun little handheld. Would have loved it back in the day, and now. Yeah. I was so jealous of the guy that I knew who... Wow, these graphics are amazing. Look how nice that looks. Wow, look at that parallax. I knew it had some, but that's nice. And it's actually got speech as well, if you can hear that. I don't know what it's saying, but it has speech. I did notice that the attack and jump buttons are the wrong way around, which is a little bit annoying. Yeah, looks like it's running really smooth. This was actually more powerful than the Game Boy Advance. This had an ARM 9 chip, whereas the GBA only had an ARM 7. So It was actually a better console than the GBA at the time. Just no one knew about it. If it had some more support, we might have seen some really cool games for it. Move towards the teleportation room. Oh, this is so exciting. I've been wanting to play this game for a long time. Whoa, okay, there we go. I would love to try and track down a physical copy, but they are so hard to come by. There was only 300 of this game ever made, and it was the only game for the GP32 that wasn't available to download on their online store, so it is literally one of the most rarest games ever made. So I will constantly be keeping my eye out in case it ever pops up. This place is so different. I should normally be in the heart of the problem. Why am I here? Okay, I guess you play as someone who gets sent around to solve problems by being teleported to different places. It looks like some weird Attack on Titan style monsters as well. There's a power up there. Can't reach it. There was one copy of this. Okay, we got levels too. Whoa, alright. That's a bit over the top. Huh. This stone is sealed by a strange force. There's no way to open the door. I'll show you what the games look like. I've got a file open that I was going to show on stream. If I go to notes, there we go. Here's all the official ones that I've found so far. So there was this person that uploaded their collection, their complete collection. So that one is Blue Angelo. That's the one I'm looking for. That's insanely hard to find. But here's the rest of them. If you ever see one of these in the wild, you'll know where they came from. Astonisher Story there. That one actually got turned into a PSP game after the GP32 had finished being on sale, which is pretty cool. I don't really know whether any of these other games came out anywhere else. I think Princess Maker 2 did. That's on a bunch of things. None of the other ones, though, as far as I know. And there's also that one, which was a separate photo. So yeah, there's not really that many. I think there are a few more. I did have a list somewhere. Let's see what that is. Oh yeah, that's one of the download websites. Well, anyway, I'm working on a video and I'll get box art for all the games. Yeah, they do look a bit mishmash. Like, that looks fine. They should have just had that logo on all of them. Or the little blue one in the corner. I guess they came out at different times. But I think they look cool. It's definitely something exciting to try and look for. Anyway, let's get back into this. We've got a proper map system and everything. They really put a lot of effort into this. Like, look at all these different abilities that you can unlock. Super dash, super jump, super slide. It's got an experience points. It's got objects. Brightness slider, I guess, if you're playing on one of the older systems. I have no idea how much they were back then. I haven't been able to find anything like that at all, really, which is kind of annoying, because I can't find any information about it. I don't even know how you would buy the games. Like, were they in stores, or were they just on a website? I really have no idea. And it also seems like a lot of the sites that did have information on just don't exist anymore. And they haven't even been backed up to the Internet Archive, which is really annoying. You're very strong. You don't know me, but I'm here to help you, guide you, show you the way to the critical point. You must travel to the east and let your instinct be your guide. I do not have any order to receive from a stranger. Go back and find a shelter to protect yourself. But did you notice that each time you kill a monster, your force increases? Yes, of course, that is my organic structure. But how? And about your ability to move fast and make extraordinary physical skill. How do you know that? Nobody should be informed about this. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Follow the east and find your goal. See you soon. Okay. Kind of a mysterious game going on. It's a little bit out of focus. Let's try and fix that. Does that look better? A little bit. There's something else I can try. Let's try that. Yeah, that looks better. I can keep my hands on the desk then. I'm still getting used to having jump and attack on the wrong buttons. I'm definitely going to be playing more of this one outside of the stream. Ah, what's going on? What's that? Someone must be in danger. Were there any accessories? There was a link cable. And there is one of those on eBay. As well. Let me see if I can find it. I'm basically following everything that I can find on eBay for the GP32. Oh, it's been a bit slow because I'm streaming. I'm just curious to see how much it is. 80. The link cable adapter is more expensive than the console. GP Link. There you go. Official link cable. It looks weird. It's a wireless link cable. I don't know how that works. It's like a Bluetooth adapter. Pretty interesting. But yeah, that's basically all there is. And there's a few games on here, look. They're not crazy expensive considering how rare they are. You can get that one for 100. That was that shoot 'em up that I played at the start. There's a few cart only ones, but I wasn't really interested in just getting the cartridge. Oh yeah, there is this as well. Like, if you don't have the ability to make the stick for yourself, you can buy this and get them all installed on it straight away, which is good if you want to save some time or money. Oh, it looks like there's a sequel to that game as well. Tomax Save the Earth Again. And I guess that was the original one? Or it's just a different coloured box? There's that beat-em-up one. That's pretty good, actually. 100 and something. Her Knights. All for the Princess. That was the one where I couldn't get past the first level. That's sealed. No way. Wow. European. New and sealed. English. Okay, that's pretty cool. Coming from Spain, so it did get physical releases outside of Korea. Here's another one. I don't know what this game is. Little Wizard. Maybe I'll try adding that one to it. Nice anime style. I like the Korean anime style. That one looks fun. Like either a beat-em-up or a platformer. The boxes actually look really nice. Nice packaging. But that's it. That's every GP32 game on there. And there's another one of those Tomax Save the Earth ones. So yeah, all the games seem to be roughly 200. I guess it is fairly expensive, but honestly not as bad as I was thinking it would be. Like, it's in the realms of possibility to, oh wow, to build up some sort of collection. I don't know how to fight this guy. I just wish there was a way to swap jump and attack. I'm gonna die. I'm dead. Game over. Does it save? It just goes right back to the intro with all the logos. I guess I didn't get far enough to save. Oh no. No. Okay. Well, let's try and put some more stuff on here. There isn't even an emulator for this, as far as I'm aware. There was one for MAME, but apparently it runs really, really slowly. So there really isn't any way of experiencing these games. Yeah, outside of playing them on the console, there really isn't any way of experiencing them. Which is crazy. It's just like, they're just going to be lost and forgotten about forever. Which is kind of sad. Right, let's see if I can get any other games on here, because for now that's everything that I had on there that worked. Let's just try a bunch of other things, and I'll share my file window so you can watch something. So here's a bunch of all the different ROMs that I found. I'll try extracting a few, and oh, there's that Kimchi Man one. Apparently that's a good game. See whether we can get that to work. And Little Wizard as well. That was the one that we just saw on eBay, so let's try that. Annoyingly, when they come through, they just come through as Game 1, Game 2. You have to go in and rename it. Let's get the keyboard back. I had to move the keyboard out of the way so I had some space. So there was a Mill one on here already. Okay, That's when it breaks, because it doesn't like... Let's try application capture instead. 1 second. Trying to find the best way of... Okay, wow, it made it tiny. Well, that will work. At least you'll be able to see me clicking through the different tabs. There. I've got to keep it in the same place, though. So what was I saying? That one didn't work, so we can delete that off there and delete it out of here as well. It's so slow using this card, like everything just takes forever. Delete that one too. Now, I don't really know how to use these emulators. I had it working before, but for some reason it's not showing up, unless there's something else that I'm missing. Looks like you can put movies and MP3s on here as well, but I'm not sure which ones. I think for the Mega Drive and Game Boy stuff, there was one of these that's missing. I think maybe one's for PC Engine as well. MSX, Neo Geo Pocket. Unfortunately, the card's not big enough to put all of these on at once. So, anyway, let's try some of these that I just downloaded. Let's try this one. So what you have to do, you have to copy that into the game folder. And then copy this one into this GPMM one for some reason. I don't know why it splits like that. streaming on Mac doesn't really seem much different to Windows, apart from it has two different options for capturing the applications. It is kind of annoying though, because if we make this fit to screen, see how it's still got the bar at the top with the Apple logo. I don't know why that's there, and that's why it came up so small. And it's still got some of the applications on the side. So yeah, it is a little weird. So I'll just do that. That seems to work. I guess it's like bin and queue files, but you have to have them in two different places. So that Genesis one, there must be something else to go with it. Here somewhere. TP. I don't know what it is, though. They're just random names. MK? I don't know. There was a Mortal Kombat demo. I think that might be that. One of these is a Guiana Sisters copy, so we'll try that. I'm still trying to figure all this out. That was another reason for doing this stream, is just to give me some time to try out all these different things and just see what works and see what doesn't. It's just so annoying that you have to be so careful with how much space you're using. Let's see if that can fit too. And look how slow it is to copy. These are like 10 megabyte games. Yeah, apparently people have been telling me that it's still really fun to program for, because it's actually got its own internal C programming compiler. So you can actually just write games in C and run them natively on the GP32, which is just really cool. And actually, while it's doing that, if I go back onto my notes, there was a website that someone gave me. Let's see, window capture. Safari. Why is it so big? There we go. Someone gave me this website, and this is an archive of all the different things that were made for the GP32 back in the day. So there's a bunch of applications, like playing audio files and stuff. Like, I guess before people had smartphones or even things like the iPod Touch and stuff, this was probably a great way of actually watching things. Like, you could download TV programs and watch them on there and stuff. You can listen to music. There's a bunch of demos and homebrew and stuff. We could try a few of these and see if we can get these to work. Let's try that 3D engine with a car. When was this made? 2005. Wait for that to download. Is it doing it? There we go. I'm a bit scared to touch the firmware. I don't know what firmware it's running. Oh, this was really cool as well. This is something else that I'm going to show off in the video. There was a bunch of fanzines that were made back then as well. And they've actually got all the issues here from like 2004, 2003. And they've got like interviews with developers. And it's just so cool that this is all backed up online from back then. So I'm definitely going to talk about some of these fanzines. That was really, really fun to find. There's a whole bunch of different games here. It looks like you can run PC game ports as well. Like, there's Doom on here, apparently a really good port of Doom, and you can upload your own WADs and get the shareware version to run it. Commander Keen, Duke Nukem 3D. So much cool stuff. Yeah, of course there's Doom. Doom's on everything. Hexen, though. You don't get Hexen on everything. Open Jazz. Nice. The latest version of Open Jazz. 2010. That was updated as recently as 2010. Wow. Sierra Online Adventures. And Scum VM as well for old Lucas games. I guess that's something you could use the keyboard for. Let's try out, see whether we can get Jazz Jackrabbit to run on here. One of my favourite PC games as a kid. We've got a bunch of things to try now, at least. And that is still copying over Bomb Jack. That's crazy. Oh yeah, let's have a look at emulators, see whether I can find a Genesis emulator. Turn your GP32 into a different machine. So let's see what it can do. It can do CPC, arcade, Space Invaders emulator. It's got MAME on there as well. I don't know how far you'd be able to get by running MAME on it. It's even got the proper MAME front end and stuff too. That's crazy. And all this was like 2004, 2005, like before smartphones existed. It's so cool. A bunch of different arcade games and ports here. Atari 2600. Coleco, Commodore. Is there no other page? Maybe there's some stuff missing. There was definitely a GP. There was definitely a Genesis. I doubt Google's going to return any results. Let's try that. Emulators on the GP32. No way can it emulate GBA games. What? Apparently. Port of Pico Drive? I don't know what that means. Recommended? Who knows? Should we try and see whether we can get one? Oh wow, it was on the Gizmondo as well. I remember using that on the Gizmondo. That's crazy. Alright, let's see what this does, if anything. This was last updated in 2014. It's crazy how long the support was for this. Alright, there was a file. Let's try adding it. See whether it does anything. I think that bomb jack one's given up. It seems to have got stuck. There you go. It's slowly. Oh no, not enough disk space. Needs an additional 55 kilobytes. How am I going to find that? Let's get rid of the Game Boy stuff for now. Ah, that makes sense. ARM-based pocket PC. I guess this is a ARM PC, kind of, just with more buttons and more of a focus on gaming. So that's pretty cool. Saying the disks full. Okay, hopefully that copies the emulator over. Hey, it doesn't matter where you found out the information. It's cool to know. All right. We should have. I don't know whether these need to be in the game folder or whether they need to be here. I think they need to be in the game folder. I'm just guessing. I've seen the folders in there and I've seen the FXE bits on this side. Let's try that. I know you can't see what I'm doing now, but I'm moving some of the files around. Alright, let's wait for that to finish and then we can eject it and give it a go. Don't want to make sure it's not going to corrupt anything with me taking it out too early. Come on, it's just spinning. They're so slow to read these discs, it's crazy. Oh, well, we're waiting. I had a exciting notification earlier on... where is it? No, I can't even show you. From Limited Run. Sea of Stars physical edition is finally shipping. Hooray! I've been waiting so long for it. Alright, it is finally ejected. Let's go. Yeah, Sea of Stars, which I backed on Kickstarter a long time ago. I'm finally getting my copy of it. Way after everyone else has already played it. I'm kind of annoyed that it took so long for them to send the physical versions out, because it's been available since last year, if you wanted to play the downloaded one. Alright, we've got a bunch of new stuff. Hey, there it is. Mega Drive Emulator Beta number 8. Let's see whether it actually loads. Hey, I did something right. GP2X Alternative Power.co.uk. Checking directories. Are they in the right place? Who knows? Come on. Is it going to make them? I don't know what it's doing. Let's just give it a minute, see what it's going to do. I probably haven't put things in the right place, have I? It doesn't want to focus on it. It really doesn't want to focus. Look at my hands, there we go. I don't think that's going anywhere. We'll figure it out. Let's try one of these. Guiana Sisters. For those of you that don't know, it was like a Commodore 64 style Mario game. And that didn't work. I'm not having much luck, am I? Let's try that one. There was two different versions of that. No, that didn't work either. Something new is going to work. Come on. Was there anything else new on there? Well, that one maybe. Everything's just looping back round. What have I done? I don't think that one worked either, did it? Game data not found. Right, there is one other thing I can do. Or actually, let's see if there's anything on any of these other cards. I haven't looked at these yet. While we're doing that, I actually have a backup which the person on eBay actually basically made a card for me. Wait. SMC is not inserted or no games exist. So I'll try copying the files over and we can see what originally came on them before I cleared it off. So, and I know there were some emulators on it that time. It might take a minute, but let's see what we can do. If we go on backup and copy, paste. Right, I don't think there's anything on this one. I don't know whether there's anything you can do to clean these either. It is a bit scary having. Okay, it doesn't like it when they're on there. Okay, that is going to take. I can't say yet, it just says preparing to copy. Anything there? No. Okay, let's put that one over there. Let's try this one. This one's another 64 gig one, 64 megabytes. Even 64 gig would be small these days. They had no idea what was coming, did they? Okay, anything on this one? I feel like these are all blank. There's nothing on that either. Just random spare cards. How can there be not enough space? I said there wasn't enough space to move over the backups. I did have a problem last time when I was trying to clear out the contents of the card. It didn't think that I'd actually deleted anything. So there's definitely a bunch of teething issues that I need to try and solve. Let's try this 16 megabyte one. Can barely fit anything on 16 megabytes, but let's see if there's anything on here. Nope. Again, there's nothing. Right. Let's bear with me for a second. I'll try and copy over the backup stuff. Hopefully, I've freed up some space. Let's try this. Yeah, I don't like having the contacts exposed. It's the same thing with the WonderSwan as well. The cartridges for that are exposed. Is there a Reddit? I haven't looked actually. Let's have a look. There might be. I'm sure Reddit was around in 2004 or whenever this was out. GP32 is a bit vague. Game Park GP32. Let's see if there's anything. Yeah, it's copying. It says it's going to be about 4 minutes. So I don't see a subreddit for the GP32. I see a bunch of people talking about it. No, there isn't. There's one for Open Pandora, which is basically what continued on the legacy of the GP32 for a bit. It was fairly popular as an open source system back around 2010-ish. Right, 3 minutes and we can check out some more stuff on there. I guess while it's doing that, I can share the screen. That's what the Pandora looked like when it loads. Ah, go away. I installed a plugin to get rid of that annoying pop-up. Pretty interesting. It was basically... I don't know why there's a random cat there. It was basically a handheld PC with gaming controls in the middle. But yeah, in terms of GP32, it doesn't really seem like there's much around. Let's take a minute to remember the granddaddy, the OG, the Game Park 32. Oh, this is a good subreddit if you want to keep up with modern emulator handhelds. There's a cool one that's coming out soon. Looks like the SP style. There it is. It looks a bit thicker than an SP, but it looks cool. And apparently it can run all the way up to Dreamcast, basically. I don't know what... they always have two SD card slots, and I don't know why you would need two. It's so weird seeing an SP with four face buttons. Game testing, let's have a look. Hopefully I can get the Mega Drive emulator working on here. Has everything moved over? Not yet. Told you it's slow. Let's see where it's up to. It says 1 minute remaining. So weird seeing 3D run so smoothly on something that looks like an SP. I'm about to ask seeing two SD card slots. Yeah, the basically all of them do. Like, it's not going to focus on it, is it? But this one's got two at the bottom. The new Mi U one's only got one, but I've got another one in the other room, which is this. If you can see that. RG something something. One of the new Anbanec ones. That one's got two SD card slots. Apparently the idea is that you can copy the operating system from one console to another. So if you've downloaded any custom firmware. This one looks really cool. Aya Neo's new analog pocket style handheld. They haven't shown anything more than just that yet, but it looks cool. I wonder whether any companies are going to send me that one over. I did have a company reach out to me earlier. I'll show you what they wanted to send. If I can find it. Can't find it now. No, I can't see it. There was one other new handheld that they were asking me whether I wanted to work with them. Can't see it. I had it on my phone earlier. Ah, there it is. I'm going to get this one soon. It looks pretty cool when it loads. like PlayStation Vita style. Their marketing stuff's always so over the top. Like you can never get anything that looks like that on it. It looks nice though. I'm not too fond of the yellow, but this transparent blue one looks cool. I don't know if that chip's any good or not. But yeah, that's something that I might be getting soon. I've got that one. That's the one I just showed. How long have we got? It still says about a minute left. 76.8 megabytes out of 91.5. That one looks nice. That's a Android-based one. Again, very similar to the PlayStation Vita. Oh my God, there is a PlayStation Vita. I do like the look of that Odin 2. Yeah, there's so many, it's ridiculous, really. And they can get so expensive as well. Wait, Aya Neo, I think. Aya Neo, have a look at their website. This one looks really nice. Look how sleek that looks. Can you still see the web browser? Yeah. Look how nice that looks. I don't know whether it's comfortable because it's completely flat on the back. But it's got really nice specs too. But yeah, some of the consoles that these guys do get insanely expensive. I think that was their like new flagship one. Like a Steam Deck competitor. But if you max this out, have a look at how much it comes out to. Nearly $2,000. Insane. Looks pretty cool though. I think the specs are probably the best you can get as well. Yeah, using the latest AMD chip. Yeah, I don't know how you'd fill up 4 terabytes, especially if you're only using it. That's what I've got, ROG Ally. I really like the ROG, but the battery life's awful. It's massive. Look, it's even bigger than the Steam Deck. Why would you want anything that big? It's insane. I quite like the look of the two, this one. Before I got the ROG, I was looking at this in white. That was going to be my second option. Oh, it doesn't actually change it. There you go. That one. That looks nice. There was a retro styled one, but I thought it looked a little cheap, honestly. I do like the design of it. Oh my God, this is going so slow. There's 134 items left. It is counting down. Retro power. What is that weird, weird fake photoshopped Wii? Look at the angle of that. That's so weird. Why have they done that? And they're showing off Wii games, and the game on the screen isn't even a real game at all. It's like some weird fake version of Zelda, I guess. Oh, yeah, there was also this really weird duck edition. Like, they were making a big deal about this, but I don't understand what's so good about that weird rubber duck. The B duck. There it is again. Why would you buy that? Maybe if you're a massive fan of rubber ducks. Would you spend £2,000 on a handheld and have a giant duck on the front of it? Maybe. Maybe I'm the one who's out of touch. Let's have a look back on here for a sec. We've only got 20 items left. It's nearly there. More ARM-based handheld consoles. Miu Mini is probably still the most popular one. Am I in any other fun fun communities. Let's see what's going on the Game Boy one. See what's going on in Wall Street Bets. I forgot about that. Shiny Pidgey on the way to get Oak Castle. Nice. There's a lot of really nice mods that people show on here. Crazy. Oh, some of the mods that people do with the Game Boy camera are insane. Right, anyway, I think we're done. Let's eject this, and fingers crossed it doesn't just collapse and die on me. There's a bunch of things on here now. We should have a nice lot of stuff to check out. Just gonna wait for it to eject. I'm really cautious about not ejecting it in case it kills the card, because even the cards themselves are really hard to find. It's still ejecting. Love your analog pocket. There's new cores. Yeah, I like it. I love the fact that you just got the dock as well. Like, anytime I want to play or record a Game Boy game, I've got my pocket right there. Whoa, that's a very reflective screen. There I am. Yeah, it's always sat in the dock. The problem is I've got the first revision and the L and R buttons don't work properly. Like, that one barely presses down. You have to be really, really hard with it. And I also kind of wish it was a horizontal handheld. And it would look nicer for GBA games, but yeah, I can't complain. The dock's probably the best thing that I got with it. I've probably used it more in the dock than in handheld. I use it with this nice little wireless SNES-style controller. I like the look of the white one as well. I was really torn between which one I should get. Right, let's see what's happening. Let's put this in. Right, let me move the keyboard out of the way again. And this stream's been a bit all over the place. Here we go. Fingers crossed something shows up. Wow, okay. We have a massive selection of stuff. Hey, did I get a new follower? I think my stream's a bit messed up. Riven Blake 32, hello. Thanks for stopping by. We're checking out this interesting handheld from Korea from 2004, which is the GP32. And I've just reinstalled the card, and there's a bunch of new things to check out on here now. Whether they work or not, I don't know. Let's check out Bomb Jack. I tried to get this working before, but it didn't work properly. Nice, it's working this time. Got some really funky music. Can you hear that? Nice. Okay. People love putting their own splash screens over everything. Hello. Oh, a drink. Thank you. I'm having fun with this. Everything's working fine.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, and I got a bunch of random things working on it. And downloaded a bunch more stuff.
Yay.
You okay?
It doesn't fit on the freezer. Thank you.
All right, I'm back. Let's check out Bomb Jack. Can you hear it? Oh, wow. I was not prepared for the frame rate being so fast. Yeah, they actually put jump on the right button this time, too. Sorry, Riven Blake. I feel like I completely ignored you then. I'm doing very well, thank you. Had a pretty good day at work as well, which is surprising, because I don't usually say that, so... Yeah, it seems like things are finally going in the right direction. Work. What am I supposed to do now? I thought you just had to pick up all the bombs. Okay, I don't think this is finished. Because that is not... That is not working. Okay, I think that's all we can do. Just a proof of concept. That's pretty cool. You can use... you can use start and select to go back to the menu. I guess that was just a proof of concept more than anything. Oh, Sarah interrupted me then because she bought herself a new 3D printer today, but it's too big. So she doesn't know what to do with it. Okay, ROM failed. Wait, I thought I could reset. I don't know how much of this stuff is going to work or not. This was just a bunch of other random files. It was supposed to live on top of the freezer, but it won't fit. Let's just go across. Let's see what this is. X-Raw. This sounds cool. What is this? Oh, I wonder whether we can use the keyboard. Let's try. No, unfortunately not. If you weren't here on stream earlier, I had this Ericsson keyboard to plug into it, but I haven't found a reason to use it yet. Most of the stuff that I've tried so far doesn't really seem to be completely functional. This doesn't seem to be doing anything. Oh, apparently it's a Dragon 32 emulator. I don't know whether there's any ROMs. Didn't seem like there was when I looked through the files. Let's see what this is. VText. It's not in English. Okay. Up, move back a line, down, move forward, left, first page. Okay. Oh, is it a book reader? Language, font. Okay, it's an ebook reader. Cool. Doesn't really seem like there's much on there. Do artwork for streamers. I don't really need any artwork, thanks, but thanks for asking. If you want to find my Discord, you can have a look on my website. You'll find a link to it. Yeah, I don't think there's much we can do on that one. That's just an ebook reader. Oh no. There's nothing there. I killed it by trying to read a book. Come on. No games exist. Have I broke it? I don't know how to clean it. I'm so worried that whatever I've done to this has just killed it. What have I done? Yeah, it's not cool to come into someone else's stream and try and do self-promotion. Like, reach out in a DM or an email or something. That's probably a more appropriate method. Okay, fingers crossed something comes through. Why is it not working? Oh man, we might have to end the stream here anyway if it's not going to load anything. It does seem a bit unstable. Let's try putting it back in the PC and see if anything shows up. Oh no, that was annoying then. Well, everything's still on there, so I didn't lose anything. Yeah, SD cards were definitely a better invention. I'll give them that. They might just be really temperamental. Come on. Yay, there we go, we're back. The problem is with these emulators, I don't know whether they had any ROMs with them. Let's see what this is. OS 9X, is that Game Boy? Oh, is that a SNES emulator? Maybe. Open SNES 9X. Cool. Yeah, it seems like these cards are just really temperamental. Loading intro. Am I going to get something? There's some music. I don't know if that's from something. It's taken a while. Anything there? Okay, let's give it a minute. Hey, there we go. We have a picture. Load in browser. It's a little bit slow. Okay, cool. We actually got a bunch of games on here. Mario All Stars. I'll never say no to a bit of Mario. Loading game. Let's see how bad this runs. Whoa, okay. I don't remember that from Mario All Stars. How are you meant to read that? What are you trying to tell me? Okay. This is some weird hacked ROM by the looks of it. Does it have sound? No sound. Any settings? Sound mode on. Stereo on. Oh, okay. So I guess that would be A. I guess there's not enough buttons, is there really? Let's try that. Right, we can get into the game now at least. Still doesn't seem like there's any sound. And they're the wrong way around, but the frame rate's a little low, it's a little bit laggy. I wasn't really sure whether this would actually be able to run SNES or not. It seems like it kind of can. Maybe it would have been passable back in the day. And something like Mario's fine, isn't it, with only two buttons, but yeah, anything more than this, you wouldn't be able to play SNES games properly on here with just two buttons. But it's all right, it's cool to see it running. And you have to remember that at the time, there wouldn't be any alternative to actually getting the SNES games to run in there at all anyway. Let's see if we can make this look a little better. Okay, that didn't work. Nothing came out of that box. Weird there's no sound, even though I told it to turn the sound on. But I am impressed. It works. Like, if you're playing something a bit slower, like an RPG or something, I could see myself being very happy with this back in school. Just the idea of being able to play SNES games at a moderately good frame rate is exciting in itself. Like, I would have been. How old would I have been when the GP came out 10, 9, something like that. I would have been super excited to be able to play this as a kid. It actually runs better than I expected, to be honest. I think there were some other games as well. Let's see how... I think Donkey Kong Country was on there. Let's see how that works. I've never gone through the normal exit on that level. Yeah, pretty impressed overall. And... yeah, probably there'd be a way to speed it up a little bit using these menus here. There's a lot of different options. Like, you can tell that people put a lot of effort into it. Or a lot of effort into the port anyway, because I remember using SNES 9X on the PC back in the day. It is very slow to load. Let's try Donkey Kong. I presume that was Donkey Kong. Come on, you can do it. It just explodes. This one might be a little slow. No sound again. I'll be intrigued to see whether it can run this full speed. I mean, that looks fine. As good as it can do on this screen. Do do do. I have to do the music for you. Do 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 do. Okay, the background's a bit messed up. There's no jungle. But again, it's playable. I mean, the frame rate's not great, as you can see. I'd say, what is it, frame skip times 2, maybe? But compared to, like, the alternative at the time, which would have been the Game Boy Color version, I'd say I'd be happy to play this as a kid. Okay. Let's try something else. That's enough of me. Oh, what happened there? I tried to turn it off and back on and it froze. What the? What? How does this power switch work then? Alright, let's try. Surely it's gone now. Okay, there we go. That was weird. I've been thinking about playing the Donkey Kong Country games on stream at some point, because I love those games so much. All three of them. They're all fantastic. Right, where are we up to? New Kind. Let's see what that is. I have no idea what this could be. Oh, Elite. Cool. Look at that. That's pretty impressive to see. Now, I have no idea how this is going to play on here. Okay. I think it just froze on me. Okay, that was an interesting start. Let's see. No. The keyboard does nothing. It looked good for a second. It's dead. That keyboard is really, really difficult to get in and out. It's supposed to have bits that you press down on, but it's just not really moving. Yeah, I think that's not doing anything. Oh, okay. No, nothing's happened. Right. Weird, the power button doesn't actually turn the power off straight away. It kind of holds it for a bit. I'm really worried every time I turn the power off, it's making the cards less and less reliable. Okay, Neo Geo emulator. Let's try that. Whoa, okay, that's cool. They loved showing off, didn't they, on those? I love these old emulator screens. Press the start key. Let's see, are there any ROMs? Right, we have. We do have a ROM. I don't know what game it was. Drag something? God damn it, it didn't do anything. Maybe there's no proper ROMs on here. Maybe that's just a placeholder thing. It's cool though. Listen to the cool music. This one was coded for a competition in 2003, by the looks of it. 15 Days Compo 2003, coded by Thunder Z. Contribution to the 15 Days Compo. Thanks, great people on the GP32 scene. Nice. Unfortunately, I didn't have any games to try on it. But I'll give them bonus points for a cool intro screen. Where are we up to? MKGP. I tried this one the other day. This was a Mortal Kombat clone. Mortal Kombat GP32. Very unresponsive from what I remember. Or weirdly smooth as well. It doesn't look right. Oh my god. Again, the AI is just kicking my ass. It looks really good though. It's almost too smooth though. You think it, like, the way they move is like a really weirdly high frame rate. I guess you can't see it too bad, too much on there. You can't really see the frame rate that well on the screen. Yeah, man, I can't do anything with these 2000s AI players. Jesus, give me a chance, come on! Die! I can't do anything. Oh my god. As for, was there any different colours? I haven't seen any different ones. So I'm not really sure. Right, I can't get anywhere on that. That's enough of that one. It's cool that it exists, though. I'll give the developer props for making it run so smoothly. Next is whatever this is, 0.3 Yo-Yo FR. No clue at all what this one could be. Little John. Wait, this is a NES emulator? Okay. They've actually got a bunch of games on here. Let's try Tetris. Brought to you by Yo-Yo. Press A button to start. Alright. Maybe they could have come up with a better name for it. Oh my god! The music. Wow. Can you hear that? Let me turn it up a bit. Oh my god, that's horrible. Okay, let's see how it plays. It's definitely skipping a few frames. It feels nice playing it with this D-pad, though. I wonder if there's any settings or if there's any better emulators. Like, if this was running at full speed, I'd be happy to play it on here. looks really nice. And the NES games actually look really nice. Like, look how... Oh, I can't pause on this, but look how clear it is. That actually looks better than some of the handheld emulators that I've played today. Like, the new ones that are coming out of China. Just a shame about the frame rate. And the, frankly, disgusting music. I don't know how to come out of it either. Maybe there's no way of coming out. I'm stuck in weird GP32 Tetris hell forever. It would be such a fun console to tinker with, though. I can imagine people really having a lot of fun with this back in the day with all the different forums online and everyone coming up with these little projects to try and build. I'm dead. I haven't got anywhere to put it. Anyway, that's enough of that. Let's see. I think there's a Game Boy emulator on here somewhere. The thing is, pretty much everything I've tried so far kind of works, but it's not quite there. Maybe this is the Game Boy? It says GP on it. GB. Maybe. Yeah, looks like it. Alright, Super Mario Land. I don't know why it's there four times. Hey, it actually sounds more or less right. It's stretched. Frame rate's good. There's something weird going on with the floor there. Okay, there is something weird going on. It's not filling the screen properly. But this plays perfectly. I wonder if there's any settings for the emulator. I feel like a lot of these are just really early in development as well, so I'm sure the bugs could be ironed out. But yeah, this looks and plays fine. Quite impressed. The floor, though, why is it lifting up some of the tiles? Like, randomly, halfway across the screen. The L and R buttons haven't done anything, like, for any of the games. That's a bit weird. I think I've found a glitch. The timer's not going down. Oh my god. Look at that, it's just going forever. Okay. You actually can't get past level one. That's so funny. It's just stuck. Forever and ever and ever. Okay, we can restart it. Is there no way of getting back to the menu or anything? No. You'd think they would put a way of getting back into the menu. I'm going to try that one again, see if there's any options. That wasn't it. It did say it was a test, though, so I guess this is just a really early emulator, and there's probably better ones. No, there's no options. It has Donkey Kong. Let's see how Donkey Kong works on this. Still throwing me off that start and select are in the wrong side. Ready to see how fast I can get through level one. Okay, this one's struggling a little bit. Dun, 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 dun. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Help, help. Dun, 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 dun. Oof. Okay, it was a little bit awkward, but I still whizzed through that level pretty fast. Oh, it froze. It just never wants you to finish a single stage on the simulator, apparently. Yep, it's dead. Okay. Well, that was a fun little thing to check out. Now let's see what else is on the list. There was some other ones as well. We can have a look at these after, but let's keep going down. GP engine that's got a Hamtaro picture. Is this PC Engine, maybe? Another cool anime-style intro screen with a bunch of stuff that I can't read. Okay, I don't even know what it wants me to try and find. Frame skip, speed, ROM type. I don't know what system this is an emulator for. Well, what do I have on here? I have some... I don't think it's for any of these. I presume it's PC Engine, but I haven't got any PC Engine games on it. It is fun to have a look, and it's kind of like looking into a different world, isn't it? It's like no one should see any of this stuff. What is this? GP... Colum? What? I have no idea what this is. This is fun. I'm glad that they included all these random things. Oh, ColecoVision. Okay, I don't think I've got any ColecoVision stuff. Come on, there's got to be something else we can actually play on this. I don't think I've had a single thing yet that actually works properly. Try the Guiana System one. I tried this before, but it didn't load. Hey, it's working this time. Nice. Press left, then right. That's a weird way of getting past a start screen. Oh, this was a more recent one, 2009. Oh, it looks a bit messed up, though. Oh, no, they gave up on it because they lost all the source code. Did it say what console it was for? I don't think this one's loaded properly. I mean, I can see it, but half the game's going off the bottom of the screen, and it looks really weird. Like, weirdly stretched. Seems smooth enough, though. Just a shame it doesn't really look right. I presume this was ported over from something else. It's a fun Mario-style platformer. I would have had so much fun with this system back in college, just discovering all the weird, quirky stuff that's made for it. Right. I wonder whether there's another version, because I remember there was two of this one. See if you can find out. I think it was PC Engine. I presume so, anyway. Right, okay, there is another version of Guiana here. Let's try that one. PC Engine and TurboGrafx. Left and right. I've never seen a menu that makes you press left and right to go past it. I don't know who that guy is. Hey, yeah, this one looks better. There we go, we can actually see it properly. Welcome to Guiana's Return. Copyright 2002 to 2009. Oh, this one's even got an intro video. I'm not here for the story. Ah, it keeps focusing on the lens. There we go, we can see now. Oh, why did it start me with an enemy right in front of me? Okay, I thought that was a power-up. Nope. Hey, this is the first game that actually looks and plays fine. Perfectly. It looks like there's a little bit of lag on the stream, but from my eyes, it seems like it's running fine. Ah, that's not fair. He was behind that rock. Ooh, nice Commodore 64 style music, too. I don't know whether you can hear the music, but have a listen. If you can hear that. I don't know whether it's coming across on the microphone or not. Pretty impressed with this, though. It looks nice. ...2009 is very late as well for a game for this system. I thought everyone had given up on it by like 2005 or something. We did it. Can I actually get to level 2? That is the next challenge. Is it loading? Maybe? Let's give it a second. It actually isn't. Am I cursed to only ever play the first level? Oh no, it is. It was just very slow. Nice rain effect. Ah! Oh no. It seems like a very basic game, though. I wonder whether there's, like, any power-ups or any different enemy... Oh, my God. Okay, that jump was too precise. Let's try. We can get past one more level, shall we? I'm just glad to have found a game that's actually fully playable. It looks all right, doesn't it? The rain looks nice. It kind of looks like a student project kind of game. Like the kind of would have made in game design class. Something on click and play or something. Oh my god, you have to be so precise to get past that. There's an enemy down there. There we go. I'm pressing B as if it's making me... That is so stupid. Why would they do that? All right. Clearly, they didn't know anything about game design, but there we go. It works, and that's better than I can say about some of the games that we've seen so far. All right, let's keep going. I'm having fun looking through all this. Hopefully, everyone in the stream is too. Right, we have ZX32 Xmas Edition. Okay, let's see what's Christmassy about this. Okay. This port is under Donationware, based on A Spectrum. Oh wow, I've got a whole bunch of Spectrum games on here, cool. I don't really know much about Spectrum. Let's just try this and see if it works. All I can do is kick? What is going on? Huh? Yeah, feeling really Christmassy now. Is this one that I need the keyboard for? Maybe. Doesn't seem to be doing anything. I'm just being attacked left and right. The keyboard's not doing anything. I don't even know if that keyboard works at all. Okay, I cannot get anywhere on that. Hooray! Another fun game. I don't know what I was expecting there, but not that. Maybe that was just a bad game. There's another Spectrum emulator there as well. Let's see what this is. FSMS32 first release, and there's a anglerfish. Again, no clue what I'm looking at all. SMS Plus. Sega Master System? Maybe? Okay, we've got a bunch of Master System games here. Let's try Bubble Bobble. A classic. Come on. Anything? Does it need time to load? Give it time. How much time shall we give it? Is it doing anything? Whoa, you can see the screen through the screen. There's some Game Boys. And Tokyo. Okay, I don't think it's doing anything. That was fun. Oh yeah. You have to wait a minute before you can turn it back on. Nope. It's still stuck. Give it a few more seconds. Okay, we're not having that much luck, are we? Alright, what is next? Okay, let's try a Commodore 64 emulator. Okay, here we go. Do I have anything? Okay, we do have some stuff. Arkanoid. How can there be a syntax error if I didn't write anything? File not found error. Great! Something else that's not working. And it crashed. Let's try that one again with the keyboard plugged in. See if we can actually write anything on that screen at least. Yeah, I don't think you'll be able to see both at once. Let's zoom out a bit. There we go. Let's move them out of the way. Let's see if we can actually get something working with the keyboard. There's another one there. Let's try that. Doesn't do anything. Why? Look how small it is as well. Imagine trying to touch type on that. It's not doing anything. Let's see if this one works at least. Hey, it's doing something. All right, that keyboard wasn't worth trying. I'll get it to work for something. Okay. It says ready. Can I play it? Auto start? Syntax error. I don't know how to get it to work. Load. Do I need to type in run or something? Run. Run. Nope. Load. Like it knows the game exists, but it won't do anything. Okay. I guess that isn't working either. We're not getting anywhere. Come on, there's got to be something. Let's keep going. MSX. I don't think we've got any MSX games. We have the little MSX penguin. Oh, we do have some stuff. Okay. Let's see if we can get Dig Dug to work. Yay, we got it. Nice. A classic. Sound enabled. We have sound. Nice, it's working. Yay, something that actually just worked straight away. I would love to get an MSX. There's like a part of gaming history that I don't know much about either. The sound's not great. Seems to be a theme with a lot of these emulators. The sound's a bit messed up. But yeah, this seems fully playable. Full speed. There we go. Yeah, the sound seems okay too. Yay, we actually got something working and playable. Maybe it's a little bit slower than normal. Let's try that. Oh, you can see in the corner how well it's running, look. So it is running at full speed. Maybe that's just the MSX itself that's slow. He's gonna escape! No, come back! Oh, I just missed him. Have we still got a chance? No, he's gone. Yeah, we can get him. There we go, we did it. Dun, 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 dun. That's good, I'm glad that worked. No way of going back to the menu again. That seems like an issue with a lot of these emulators. It's like, there should be a home button or a menu button or something. The only way to go back is to turn it on and off. But that was good. We found something else that actually works properly. That's two. I guess the Game Boy one kind of counts as working. All right. Okay, let's try this one. Looks like a Mega Drive or Genesis emulator. I doubt this is going to run at full speed. That's a crazy screen. Look at all the sprites on that. Nice. First public release. Right, what should we try on here? Micro Machines? Outrun. Let's try Outrun. I'll try Sonic. Oh, it didn't work. It kicked me out. Let's try that again. Maybe that was just a bad choice of game. Okay, let's try Sonic, because that menu moves way too fast. No, it's not working. I'm sure I tried this one the other day and it worked. Or yesterday when I got it. There might be another Mega Drive emulator somewhere else. Let's see what this is. FGB32. Is this the Game Boy one? Is this another Game Boy emulator? Yeah, it looks like it. Okay, let's try... Oh my god, this one's too fast! At least I can see all the screen this time. Well, it's in a weird tiny box. I guess that gives you a good idea of the resolution of the GP32 screen, at least. But yeah, this is too fast. Even for me. Let's see if it breaks at the end of the first level or whether I can actually finish it at least. The sound is good apart from it being too fast though. Dun, 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 dun. Is it actually going to get to the end? Yeah, you can see how much more resolution the GP32 has. Oh my god! Yeah, it works. I feel like I've drank 10 monster energies, though. And again, there's no menu at all. It's literally, here's the game. Too bad it's squashed in a tiny box and running at like 200% speed. You'll just have to live with it. I don't mind playing it this fast, honestly. Okay. Oh my god. I feel like I was getting a bit too excited then. That was a bit crazy. Cool, though, to see a different style of Game Boy emulator. Where are we up to? Call 32. Is that ColecoVision? These are all really early development things, I guess, then. Wow, there's a whole bunch of games on this one. I don't know any ColecoVision games. Do you guys know any? Can't go wrong with Frogger. Where is he? There we go. Oh no! Ah, God, I hate Frogger. Oh, you're supposed to get him in the gaps in between, aren't you? Oh my god, Frogger just gives me anxiety. Ah! Well, it works. I suck at Frogger, but it works. So that's the ColecoVision emulator. Where are we up to? Don't know what this is. Castaway GP. No idea what we're in for here. It's taking time to load this one. Okay. No idea what we've got on this one. A black screen. Again, let's give it a second. You can see the camera. That's how I've got it set up over the top of the monitor. I presume it's doing something. Let's give it a second. And I'll stretch. Well, I can't show off my new Mega Man t-shirt from Uniqlo. What do you think of that? Looks really cool. Does it say anything? Yeah, it says Mega Man at the bottom. Is that doing anything? It'd be nice if there was a loading bar or something at least. I don't think it's doing anything. Some of these things might be for the 2X instead of the 32, maybe. I bought a bunch of the Uniqlo t-shirts. We got the one with all the Capcom characters on the front as well, and the other Mega Man one. And Sarah bought the, what's it called? The Resident Evil 4 one. I think that was from there anyway. What have we got? Hey, we've got Arkanoid. Cool. I couldn't play it before, so. Classic. Let's see whether this version works. Nice. This one actually fills the screen really nicely, too. This is like a native port of the arcade game, then. Nice. Pew, pew, pew. I always love getting the lasers. The light just got really bright in here. Sometimes the lights in this room just randomly get a lot brighter. I don't know why. Oh my god, I'm not paying attention. I don't know whether to look at the preview on the monitor or look down at the handheld. Phew, let's warp. Yeah, I like this one, if you can get the ball stuck at the top. There we go. Oh, it didn't work. Not for long. Hey, it's good to find something that's actually fully playable. Oh my god, my luck playing this game today is awful. I just want to go up the top. But it actually sounds perfect as well. Not that there is much, you know. It doesn't take much to sound good. I can just skip it again. Anyway, pretty good. I'm impressed with that. Nice to see what someone actually put effort into making something run smoothly on this. Let's see, what's next? There's only two more. I think we already looked at that bomb jack one, didn't we? Yeah. In that case, there's only one more thing to check out, and then I guess we're done for the stream. So let's enjoy this last look at something GP32 related. Oh, nice. Yeah, we've got the proper intro. Whoa, really nice speed as well, and better than the Mega Drive version. Okay, this is a good bit to end it on. Let's turn the light off so you can see it properly. Okay, wow, I'm impressed by this. And the sound sounds really good too. I don't know whether you can hear it or not. Wow, you can hear that. I'm really impressed with how smooth this is. This was a really big deal back in the day as well, this game was. It was like the first big cinematic style adventure game like this. With basically early FMV, I guess. I'm not really too fond of the gameplay though. But yeah, these graphics were mind-blowing at the time. Nice, I used to have it on the SNES as well. Whoa. It never looked this good on the SNES though. This is really impressive. Okay, let's see how it plays. Wow, this is so smooth. Oh my god. Okay, wow, we have ended on a high note. But, yeah, be warned, I really, really suck at this. I don't think we're supposed to go that way. We're meant to... Oh, that's it. Hold A. Run away from that monster that comes up, aren't you? Oh, yeah. I'll die from being scratched by a worm. This is what games were like back then. But wow, in terms of the production values and getting this to run oh my god, I can't get anywhere. The intro is definitely the best thing about this game. Let's see if we can at least get somewhere. I don't know. Oh, maybe you can kick them? It's been a long time since I attempted to play this. Nope, you're not allowed to kick it. It's so weird seeing it run at such a smooth frame rate as well, like playing it on the SNES or the Mega Drive. It's like 10 frames a second. Okay, can I jump over it? Ugh. There we go. Oh my god, how are you supposed to get anywhere in this? I did actually really like their PS1 game. What's it called? Heart of Darkness. It's kind of a much more streamlined attempt at this style of adventure game. Okay, I think I've probably messed up now. I remember something about running away from... Hey, I did it. Nice. Yeah, now you gotta run back the other way. Oh my god, watch me get scratched by a snake on the way back. And then eaten by that weird boar creature. Alright, let's see if we can do it. Definitely ending on a high note though. This port is amazing. Okay, we got across. We could get back. Yes! Oh no, there's two there now. Yeah, we did it! Ah, he's getting too close! What the hell? How are you supposed to get any faster than that? Am I dead? Can you just run the other way to begin with? I don't know how to go any faster than that. I'm getting good at jumping over them at least. Alright, there we go! Okay. That's enough. Right, I've exhausted everything that I was going to look at in terms of the GP32 for today at least. I'll go away and have a play around with this in my own time and try and work on a video. You have to kill the slugs and then you can run. Oh, nice. Yeah, I'll have a look more in depth about the GP32. Try and get some of the other physical retail releases if I can. And yeah, look forward to a video on this maybe in a few weeks' time, maybe in a month's time, if I can try and find some more stuff. Thank you so much, Past the Plunger, for being with me on this stream. It's been a little bit quiet, so I did appreciate the company. Thanks for that. And yeah, hopefully I'll have more to share on this soon. I'm going to try and see whether I can find some more stuff that actually works properly. But yeah, thanks everyone. Hope you enjoyed taking a look at the GP32. It was a really interesting bit of kit, and I'm very much looking forward to researching some of the history and the background. Oh yeah, if you were wondering as well, just takes two AA batteries, and I have no idea how long they last. And yeah, I'm genuinely impressed, and I would have really loved to have this as a kid in the early 2000s. But yeah, thanks so much. Take care, everyone, and hopefully I'll be back to streaming more regularly soon. So yeah.